This is the Insomniacs Anonymous podcast, now serving over 150 Pokemon. Today on the podcast, we celebrate the birthday of Firetits McGee in this YouTube-exclusive episode. Join us as we play cards against humanity and make our already dirty minds even dirtier. We also touch on some gaming and life news for each of us, but mostly we're here to get down and dirty with cards against humanity. Wish Firetits a happy birthday in the comments, and we'll see you up ahead.
Welcome to the Insomniacs Anonymous podcast for, we're going to call it Friday Fun Night because it's also our Cards Against Humanity night, and we're going to somehow try to play Cards Against Humanity and talk about our stupid lives and talk about wonderful things and games too. All at the same time.
What?
Yeah. It's going to be awesome. Take a
totally.
Shot. I'm filling in for Brian at the moment because we still fired him out of a cannon. We're going to stuff him back into the cannon because he's actually in a different channel. And he's actually stuck in a game at the moment. So
He's walking back from the time we fired him out of the cannon.
Right, right.
He doesn't love us. He doesn't love us.
Yeah, he doesn't love us. We need to fire him out of
the game.
Why
am I not in
game
anymore? Why am I not in game anymore?
I don't know.
Alright, I guess I gotta leave game because it kicked me back to the fucking... Man.
No, you were still here.
Having...
Technical difficulties, but says you left the game.
There we go.
Yeah, good.
So in our cards game right now, we have SquaZ. The SquaZ. We have the Firetits McGee. We have
Hi.
Scrumptious Drippy Char Vagina Vulva, my bad, which I think is Shro.
Of course it's Shro.
Myself, XXX underscore MLG DudeTube underscore XXX.
I have to point out that the X's are both uppercase and lowercase.
Yes, alternating between upper and lower in that order. And Rinieri is somewhere.
Lost in cyberspace. As
he can't link me the goddamn password again.
Just scroll up.
Scroll up. It's like the last thing I posted. It's also the link and stuff. SquaZ, you has the floor?
I do. So let's first get the black card out of the way. The CIA now interrogates enemy agents by repeatedly subjecting them to blank. Let me point out that we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 custom card decks for this, and they are called Ninja Pack 1, A Phantom Penis, Ninja Pack 2, Attack of the Penis, Ninja Pack 3, Revenge of the Penis, Ninja Pack 4, A New Penis, and Ninja Pack 5, The Penis Strikes Back.
The Return of the Penis has not been released yet, and we also don't have Rogue Penis, or Penis 1, whatever that's supposed to be, or The Penis Awakens. Because those don't exist yet. But we're hoping. One day.
I see your Schwartz is as big as mine. Let's see how you handle it. Let's see how you handle it.
Ouch.
All right.
Hopefully not like Pizza the Hut. All right.
The CIA now interrogates agents by repeatedly subjecting them to an 80-inch penis.
80, folks.
Scrotum tickling and a sad hand job.
Aww.
Just because I misread it and now it's this one. This is amazing. 80 inches, yes.
What did you read it as before? 8?
And the birthday girl is on the board.
Firetits McGee has won the point. We are playing to what, 10?
10.
10, okay.
I told you to change that shit four times.
Well, maybe he didn't want to.
Maybe he didn't, apparently. I drink to forget stuff. You said that already. I'm a dum-dum.
We were talking over her, so I don't think anyone would have heard that.
And it's my fault, too.
Damn it, Shro. Fire you out of a cannon. See how you like it.
I drink to forget blank.
I drink to forget Texas.
That's a good thing to try and forget.
I drink to forget kissing my own pillow at night. I drink to forget Republicans. I drink to forget the heart of a child.
Yay, boom. I'm on the board. I was Republicans.
Republican National Convention is still in my city right now, and I'm really ashamed.
Before I go to sleep, I generally enjoy blank.
I'm just going to dip my hand here and say, wow, I'm getting a lot of scrotum cards.
That's good.
It's the ninja pack.
Well, now I know which one's yours, Shro. Before I go to sleep, I generally enjoy vigorous Chaz hands. Before I go to sleep, I generally enjoy anal bleeding. God.
Oh, Jesus.
Before I go to sleep, I generally enjoy fondling your scrotum. Before I go to sleep, I generally enjoy my best friend's collection of hentai.
Ooh.
The last one's true, but I'm going to pick this one. Firetits McGee has won the board with anal bleeding.
Birthday girl's owning us.
Yes. By the way, did we mention it was her birthday? Forget.
No, you didn't.
If you didn't, I didn't know.
Well, it's Firetits McGee's birthday, and since it's not, like, a copyright thing to sing this anymore, we should totally sing this.
We do.
No, fuck no. Just
do it.
No.
Please.
Happy birthday
to you. Happy birthday.
Never mind.
Miss McGee of Fire.
Happy birthday to you. Okay, that's copyrighted. Don't do that.
Best rendition ever.
Okay, Shro, read the card.
In my opinion, blank is a much more advanced product than blank.
Was that supposed to be in?
Yes.
Shit, what was the? I can't remember. Morgan Freeman. Was it supposed to be in his voice?
What?
I heard that a little, like bit like.
How
Morgan
did you hear
Freeman.
That? Out?
I don't know.
I'm going for like spoiled,
spoiled lawyer.
No, I'm literally thinking spoiled wively plantation owner from the 1800s.
Oh, I got like Morgan Freeman from that. It's like a tiny bit of Morgan Freeman.
I feel like Morgan Freeman's insulted because I totally wasn't trying.
It was actually pretty good.
In my opinion.
In my opinion. Blank is much more advanced product than blank.
Oh, go for it.
Oh,
no, I'm good.
Oh, okay.
Done.
Well, that and it's
in
also
my
your
opinion.
Turn.
A bag of magic beans is a much more advanced product than butt plugs.
Lies.
You can just shove as many beans as you need in there.
It's true. And they grow.
Adjustable. More beans than plugs.
In my
Tell
opinion,
that fucking beanstalk comes fucking flying out of your ass. No.
Flying.
It's like
flying.
That episode
it
of
has
South
velocity.
Park.
In my opinion, a park full of obese children is a far more advanced product than fabricating statistics. Is fabricating statistics actually a product?
It's a product of the, of politics, I'm sure.
It's a marketing product.
And lies! Lies!
A pack of cigarettes is a much more advanced product than surprise sex. You get the cigarettes for after the sex.
Again, lies.
In my opinion, let it rip is a much more advanced product than trying to pee while having an erection.
That's legit. That is legit.
I mean, it's okay if you sit down
peeing
at
while
home,
having an
dude.
Erection
peeing
is
a fucking
one of
boner?
The best feelings in the world.
The art,
why you
man.
Go in the shower.
You can just kind of twirl that thing and go everywhere. And
yeah,
flexibility. Wow, erection flexibility. Kudos. I think I
anyway,
too much.
I think the erection.
God damn it!
I think the beans went.
What the
yeah.
Fuck?
Maybe it's a good thing we didn't set this to 5. Miss
God
Fire
damn it, tits.
All of
this
the
would
fun.
Have been, like, best of 3 rounds, then. By the way, Firetits McGee won with butt plugs.
True.
Whenever I want to get out of doing something, I just say that I'm blank.
By the way, we haven't really discussed a topic yet. Should we try or no?
I was going to do one round of the cards, and then the Czar would talk about things.
Okay.
Sometimes I don't have that fresh feeling.
Things never bother me. I'm happy and fine.
I like douche.
Sounds like he got grabbed by a cold hand.
Now I need to find.
Ooh.
Whenever I want to get out of doing something, I just say that I'm being bullied at home school.
Aww.
It's just sad. Whenever
Mom,
I want to get out
Mom,
of doing something,
it,
I just say that I'm Dick Cheney. Oh, no. Whenever I want to get out of doing something, I just say that I'm genital piercing. Ah. Whenever I want to get out of doing something, I just say that I'm that one gay Teletubby.
Oh. And it just came back on TV, and my son loves it. It makes me cry.
It's like a new series, or is it just reruns?
No, it's the original Teletubbies, but they just started redoing it again. My husband, like, my son loves it, and it makes me cry that he loves it.
And Shro won the last round with being bullied at home school.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy.
How this will work. Once the card czar reads their card, which is currently Mr. SquaZ, then, or SquaZ, we're going to go with SquaZ.
SquaZ. That's not.
Once SquaZ reads his black card, then he can talk about what interesting things he's done in gaming, or just in general life, and take his time to do that, and then once everybody submits their cards, we'll go ahead and read them and keep doing that. For another round.
Sounds good to me.
Sounds like a plan. Before he died, Robin Williams' guilty pleasure was the. Well, actually, that's an idea. They've been playing Jumanji on TV for, I don't know, the past 3 weeks here.
Yeah.
And
it's a good movie.
It is. And you go back there and you're like, what's that actress? She plays in the original Spider-Man.
Kirsten Dunst.
Yes.
She was like 12 in that movie. You're like, no way.
Yep.
What? Just watch her in Interview with a Vampire.
Yes. Yes. It was great, that fucking movie.
Well, that was a good movie. All right. Before he died, Robin Williams was guilty. Blah, let me try again. Robin Williams' guilty pleasure was passable transvestite.
He was a passable transvestite in the movie. Scoutfire.
Hello!
I feel like I've offended somebody by now.
For sure.
It's okay, that's what we do.
Guilty pleasure was Hulk Hogan's sex tape. It's my guilty pleasure.
Yeah, brother. We pulled this fucking chick harder. Yeah, brother, stick it in my butthole. Hulkamania, little penis running wild.
William, I'm going to keep going now. Robin Williams' guilty pleasure was my third nipple. Damn it, how'd I know? Robin Williams' guilty pleasure was playing a children's card game.
Probably, because he was into World of Warcraft. He might have been into Yu-Gi-Oh!
He was also just a nerd.
He named his daughter Zelda. That's fucking awesome!
I know, amazing. Right?
So I will admit, Zelda Williams doesn't roll off the tongue.
Yay, I won with Hulk Hogan's sex tape.
Oh, yes, it does.
Oh, my. Miss McGee! Fabulous, Alia Babwa.
In desperate times of need, we must stop and ask ourselves, what would blank do?
You gotta do it like in a southern pastor accent.
That's what my attempt was, but I'm not as good as doing that kind of shit as you are. Okay?
Sorry.
Like, I attempted.
You nailed it. Sorry.
Look at all these words that I'm shoving back into my mouth.
Wow, this just went way.
You should do that. I did. Well, you nailed it. Sorry.
I think this is the most fun episode we've had.
Oh, we need to go yell at Brian to get his fucking butt in the channel.
Yes, do that. Do that thing.
Wait, we could actually just invade his channel.
Oh, shit.
We could, but then we'd be part of one-sided Overwatch discussion.
Yeah, he would just randomly rush out random shit. Round the point! Okay.
Well, right, there's nobody else in this channel for him to shout out, so I don't know. Never mind. Anyways.
I'm sorry.
Firetits McGee.
Merry Christmas.
Cut that out.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry.
Noted.
Wait, now you have to say the name really monotone and slow.
Yeah, do it. Actually, like, make it terrible, please. I'm making a bunch of notes here.
Firetits McGee.
2-1. Cut. Ow.
Ow.
I hurt myself.
He said cut, so I just grabbed the nearest sharp object and just started stabbing.
I just slapped myself in the face. Cut. Ow.
Should I even just cut that out? Just like put a censor bleep over it?
You could just bleep it out. That would be kind of funny.
I'll do that. Let's keep going. Just let me know when I need to cut
the word I just said that was bleeped. It was bleep.
Oh my. Okay. In desperate times of need, we must ask ourselves, what would the vaccine that cures autism do? Makes no sense, but that's okay. In desperate times, we must ask ourselves, what would explosions do? Blow shit up. In desperate times, we must ask ourselves, what would my genitals do?
Everything.
Then fuck the problem. That's all.
My genitals had a dream.
And it was a wet dream.
Wet dream.
Jesus. I have a dream. That one day.
Okay.
In desperate times, we must ask ourselves, what would Hurricane Katrina do?
Fuck shit up. That's what she would do.
Actually, the time I was like, I want to do it, the Southern Baptist pastor voice, but at the same time, I wanted to sing, what would Brian Boitano do through that? I don't know why.
That's perfect.
Well, I like that when you first
started. Yeah, I'm on the fucking board.
There you go.
My genitals won, and Rinieri got the point.
Ew. I'm sorry, my name is not Rinieri right now. It is Full-Time Birthday Spanker.
Okay, Full-Time Birthday Spanker.
Get it right.
Life was difficult for cavemen before blank. I went to go see the new Star Trek movie today.
I forgot that it came out today.
It came out today? I thought it was, like, out for a few days.
Really?
I thought so.
Well, I mean,
so.
Technically everything comes out like Thursday at midnight now.
Okay.
You got in. But I don't know. I did not know it was even out for the next month or so.
I loved it. It was awesome.
For what?
For what?
Star Trek. I want to go see it.
It's good. Go see it. My parents wanted to go see Ab Fab whenever that's supposed to come out.
The fuck
is that?
There's a... Okay. See if I can explain
Wait,
this properly.
Hold on. 3, 2, 1, everyone say, the fuck? Three, two, one.
Okay. So, for those that don't know, it is a BBC show about two women and one of their daughters.
Menstrual cycles?
I guess. Sort of. Not
Wait,
really.
Seriously?
There's an actual show called Absolutely Fabulous on BBC.
Oh, I've heard of this!
Yeah, they're getting a movie.
Yes!
And My parents really wanted to see it, but it's not out yet. But Star Trek was one of the two choices we had for movies to see, and I talked them into Star Trek.
Go see Absolutely Fabulous or yes. Star Trek.
Pretty much.
What the fuck? Wow. That is two completely
those
different.
Those are not allowed to be compared to each other, like,
not,
for any reason.
Like, I had to talk them into Star Trek first.
That's fantastic.
Okay. Life was difficult for cavemen before opposable thumbs. Well, I'd imagine. It's just accurate. You can't grab your penis that well without
cavemen
opposable thumbs.
Cavemen had fucking thumbs!
Life was difficult for cavemen before genocide.
Well, okay, that's legit.
Okay, yeah. Life was difficult for Kidman before the immaculate breasts of Kate Upton.
Oh my god. Again.
That's legit, too.
Ugh.
We went the accurate route this round.
Oh, yeah, except for this last one, I think. Life was difficult for Kidman before feeding Rosie O'Donnell.
Hey, everyone needs.
Then
to
it got
out.
Really impossibly
everyone,
hard.
Yeah. They had to have some sort of livestock, so that fits the niche right there. Feeding. Come on.
Is she still relevant anymore?
Not
feeding
really.
She attempts to be. She's having problems with her daughter, and her daughter keeps running away.
Oh, I wonder why.
Yeah, that's fucking funny.
Genocide wins it with SquaZ on the board now.
Come on.
Yay.
Rosie and Anna was screaming. Come on.
No.
It was perfect.
Nothing quite says I love you like blank. And I have not done a lot of gaming recently.
Yeah,
but,
you still need to get your computer fixed.
Oh, I don't know. I don't think I picked the right person to play this fucking card.
Ooh.
need to refresh my browser. Oh, there we go.
I've been doing a lot of real world stuff, trying to get things fixed and running again, and helping a friend fix things. As well as, you know, the fun stuff of, like, you know, paying off debts and making sure I have car insurance and knowing that I hate my job enough that I might have walked out earlier in the week, but I didn't. But
cool
I
story, man. Read your cards.
Yeah.
He's allowed the story.
That's pretty much it, though. For once, the Shrove story is very lame and lackluster.
Thank fuck, it's short this time, at least.
I know, and right?
Yeah.
Then,
so, I don't want to have to cut
at least
up a
it didn't
20
last
minute story.
3.5 hours.
Oh, well, that's a ghost.
Yeah.
Story.
Yeah, but those are fun. Shrows are, like, long-winded and, like...
Don't go anywhere, and there was a point, but it got lost in, like, Albuquerque.
Yeah.
Like, 4 hours ago.
Albuquerque.
By the time you kind of come back to the original thread, you've lost all train of thought and you've completely derailed it.
The audience has lost 17 brain cells exactly, and they're drooling out one side of their face.
True. I'm going to confess that I've actually walked out on your stories and came back and you were still talking.
Oh, I believe it. I would not be surprised.
I literally walked out, like made myself a sandwich or something. I can't remember what I did. I just know I put everything down and then came back and you're still rambling about yourself. I'm like, uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
I don't feel bad. I did the same fucking thing. That's awesome.
Oh, I'm pretty sure everybody's done it.
I'm probably sure, like, to the bathroom.
Okay, let's be honest with this. I am so tied in with the phone and the computer and all that. I've walked away from myself because I've used my phone.
I have not walked out on your stories yet, and now I think I should.
Yeah,
you know, that's so appropriate because we've completely stepped away from the fucking game. Continue.
No, right? Nothing quite says I've been trying. Nothing quite says I love you like impotence.
Impotence, isn't it?
Impotence.
Oranges, oranges. Potato, tomato. Words. Nothing quite says I love you like a Jehovah's Witness.
Oh my.
Have you heard the good news about our Lord and Savior, Zool? Hi, Brian.
Brian, hi!
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Say hi. I don't
recognize this person. I don't understand who the hell this person is.
I know. They've been away too long.
It's a Jehovah's Witness.
Hey, there it is.
Do you have a moment to hear about the sacred
the fappening,
word,
which is the next card?
The sacred word of the
Zool.
Cats.
Zool. Or that.
There is a sacred word of horny cat that goes from Where is Katie when we need her?
That actually sounded like
I don't know.
Nothing quite. Get her ass on today.
Well,
tried.
Okay, I'm halfway through it. Nothing quite says I love you like the fappening, and nothing quite says I love you like ripping a cat right now. Oh, oh my god, that was a little more on point than I thought it would be.
I love you.
And everybody, this is Brian Guitar Dude. If you forget him, he used to be on the podcast and then got fired out of a cannon and then found his way back here.
A long, long time ago in a land far, far away.
Come on! The cat should have won, fucker!
The fappening
come on! Loving somebody so hard that it's a fappening apocalypse. It's the fappopolyx.
What?
Wow, that's harder to say than I thought it would.
Tried to say a word and he stroked it. Jesus, I'm sorry.
We broke show.
Oh yeah. Yeah, we finally
brought the orgy to a grinding halt.
I need a beer.
Did we say more?
So how have you been, Brian?
Been pretty good. I can't complain.
Hey,
you know,
when
we went to that other channel, you were talking to yourself a little bit.
I tend to do that sometimes, you know.
Wish we could tell you to shut the fuck up! But we, you know, went to another channel. Oh, because we love you. Oh, my.
Oh, God.
What brought the orgy to a grinding halt? AIDS. What brought the orgy to a grinding halt? The milkman.
Why wouldn't he join?
Okay. I got milk.
He usually adds to it.
Yeah, exactly. That's every porno, any delivery guy joins.
Exactly. So, especially the milkman, because guess what he does?
Brings the milk.
He milks people.
Oh, that's a farmer.
Well, now he's... he could moonlight as a farmer. Oh, no.
So I'm really hoping somebody's going to go psychonauts on us, but it's not happening.
I'm the milkman. My milk is delicious.
Yes.
There we go.
Are you doing grinding halt? God. God does that a lot to everything.
He's watching you, and you,
children.
And you.
You better not masturbate, because Grandma's watching you up in heaven.
He knows when you are sleeping. He knows when you are fapping.
That's Santa Claus and equally creepy.
That's the same thing.
Pretty much.
Not really, no.
I'll take mythical creatures for 800. Oh, sorry. Let me move on.
Oops.
Somebody what caused the orgy to a grinding halt? Men. Whoa. Lesbian. Hello. Lesbian orgy. Get that penis out of here.
Best kind of orgy.
Lesbian?
It's raining, man. Oh my god, it's raining.
Get him out of here. What brought the orgy to a grinding halt? Chewbacca completely shaven.
Oh my.
I'm cold.
Hon, come over here and warm me up.
So I was one with Chewbacca completely shaven.
Because he only went there to get a fucking blanket. He was really cold.
And to warm right. up, considering it's an orgy, and that happens to warm you up in cold. Era in cold life.
I'm
place.
Sorry. Like,
yeah.
If Chewbacca had sex with a real, like a fucking human, he would tear that bitch in half.
Probably.
Yeah. Brian, just to clue you in, we were having the cards ours each read their cards and then, you know, rabble on about something they were doing in recent times, gaming or whatnot. So you are now the card czar, having now just joined us. Read your card.
So today on Jerry Springer, I am married to blank, but I can't stop thinking about blank! Exclamation mark.
Exclamation mark.
You cut out just at the right time so you didn't say the second blank. But I can't stop thinking about exclamation mark.
Can't stop thinking about
Amazing.
I don't have a person in mind. Yeah, whatever.
It's so quiet.
So what have you been up to, Brian, that we could talk to the podcast about?
I've been playing all the freaking Overwatch. That's what I've been doing.
Have you played Ana yet?
Well, I mean, we did play on the brawl mode or whatever it's called for a while. Yeah, you know, it was brutal. Totally brutal.
It's too late to shut up and read the cards.
All right, just
let's see. Today on Jerry Springer, I am married to the Amish, but can't stop thinking about my right nipple. Because, I mean, who hasn't been through that, you know, situation before?
Exclamation mark.
I am married to man meat, but can't stop thinking about having sex with your mother. Just for shits and giggles! Exclamation mark. I feel like that's probably a dude run thing. I don't know. Maybe it's just me.
You'd be wrong.
I am married to Gandalf, but can't stop thinking about my dirty little secret. I am married to 2.5 women. Sounds complicated. But I can't stop thinking about the 9th graders.
That's the half woman.
Oh, I get it. That's
or one of the half women, since it's plural.
Oh my!
Well, that's kind of creepy, yo.
I've got 2.5 women in my bathroom.
Maybe you're dating 5, considering it's like the 9th graders is plural. You could date 5 of them, and that'd be 2.5 women.
I can stop thinking of 9th graders.
Yeah.
Hmm.
The 9th graders.
The 9th graders. The whole class?
Just 9th graders in general, you know.
That goes back to that orgy card.
Oh my.
We here at IA do not condone pedophilia.
Condone orgies.
I was going to say, are they 18 by grade 9? But then I'm like, no way, that's grade 12. No,
I mean, unless you've been held back so long. But then again, it'd probably be better to just do
like
6
years, you know, then at that point, I guess.
So like the setup for a porno right there, like to have, like, she's in 9th grade. She was held back like 6 times.
She's got a unibrow. She fucking knuckles are dragging the ground.
I like to learn how to read. I like to speak good words.
Sounds like Jerry Springer, I am married to Eminem, but can't stop thinking about Sarah Palin.
No!
Exclamation mark! Yeah.
No.
Sarah Palin, if she doesn't speak, she's fucking hot. But as soon as words like escape her mouth, it's like, oh my god, put a
slippery slope, dark tunnel.
I don't know. I feel like maybe I'm a little too, young to find her attractive.
See, yeah, I'm sorry, man. She's hot.
All right.
She's hot.
Send me a picture of her in like 15, 20 years.
I wouldn't want that then. Hell no.
Well, not a she's current picture of her 15 kinda years from now, but like a current
for
this
time. Send me a current picture of her from today, but like 20 years from now.
Yeah.
Yeah, and like, I'm going to be alive then. Oh my god.
Come on! You're still going to be alive by then. Don't say
that. The amount of shit food that I eat right now, if I don't have a heart attack in the next 5 years, I'll be very surprised.
Yay, I won. Thank you, Brian.
See, I knew it. I knew.
And having sex with your mother for shits and giggles.
I knew that was a dude run thing.
Goddamn incest is the key. Goddamn it.
Exactly. Incest is when
incest is the key.
Major League Baseball has banned something for giving of players an unfair advantage.
Something?
Something. It's blank.
Something.
Yeah, so about them Olympics and then the Russian doping, anti-doping committee. I guess
how
about
them Olympics and the fact that like a bunch of teams aren't going because Brazil is collapsing, rot with criminal activity, and there's this whole Zika, you know, might make you infertile virus.
It doesn't make you infertile. It totally does not make you infertile. It gives your babies microcephalia, which is tiny heads.
That's.
I was pretty sure there was a like mental retardation aspect to that too.
That's what tiny heads do.
I heard hands.
No, don't you? Heads. Tiny heads.
Tiny heads.
Tiny hands would be whatever Donald Trump has.
That's about to say.
We're gonna go down that slope. We might as well just go all the way.
Oh, you can't go much further. His hands are only so big.
True.
Major League Baseball has banned getting to third base on the first date. Damn words, for giving an unfair player advantage. Again,
unfair advantage.
And third base of the first date went out with the unfair advantage of the band and the major bases ball.
See,
John Madden.
That's like a Bill Cosby thing there. Hey, Major League, the first date. What?
So what's the difference between Bill Cosby saying that and Ozzy Osbourne saying that?
You heard one of them because you weren't drugged.
Ozzy. Hey! Ozzy's got a fucking British accent, so which is like 1,000 times cooler.
I just love that show because they have to subtitle everything he says because nobody knows what's coming out of his mouth.
It's just like you hear the whole Sharon! I heard that. Understood that.
Major League Baseball has banned an infusion of HIV-tainted tiger blood for giving players an unfair advantage.
Eh? Do I have to subtitle you now? Because I heard, like, infection.
Subtitling a podcast, that could be funny.
Well, I could do it on YouTube, but that would take too long, because it's, like, an hour long, probably. I don't have time for that shit.
You time code that shit.
I could, but I don't want to have to type out an hour-long podcast where several people are talking over each other.
Just Squaz being unable to form words about Major League Baseball.
Major League Baseball has banned actual cannibal Shia LaBeouf for
Shia.
Fuck you.
Shia.
Wait.
French.
Did you... Please tell me you want to say his name, LaBeouf.
It's LaBeouf.
Actually, the cannibalism is Michel LaBeouf. What the fuck did you just say? He's French Canadian. Give him a pass. Okay.
Is the actual cannibal Michel LaBeouf?
Michel LaBeouf.
Major League Baseball has banned slow motion for giving players an unfair advantage.
Exclamation point.
Period.
Yes. Exclamation point.
Exclamation
time
point.
Of the month, period. Major League Baseball has banned parental handjobs for giving players an unfair advantage, okay?
I feel like you're a mob boss now.
Okay.
You're the evil mastermind.
Brian is on the board with slow motion.
Oh, yeah.
Finally.
God. Showing up half an hour fucking late. What I do?
I absolutely hate it when people try blank just to anger the fuck out of me.
So what's been going on with you? Firetits McGee. Or did you answer that?
Throwaway card.
I forget.
Censored!
Shit. Firetits McGee.
Yes. Firetits McGee.
We need to come up with an obnoxiously long name for you, Miss Firetits.
Fireturbergerderger.
See, I can edit myself out because my audio file and your guys's is separate. So I can do whatever.
Oh, I'm separate from the fucking group.
I still think it was great when Joe said Fire Tits' name, and then we had to splice it in, and he was like, Fire Tits, my guy.
It wasn't even legible. Awesome.
Firetits McGee.
Firetits McGee.
Firetits McGee.
I tried to re-record an audio. This is an old audio cassette tape of me trying, like, pretending that I'm falling. And of course, I'm like, horrible editing. So I was like, splice. Butchered it.
It's like sound like you're going Super Saiyan, but in reverse. Kind of.
Yay!
That's almost like having an orgasm.
Like it hurts to power down.
Okay. Whoever played the first, the third card, fuck you. Okay.
You know, oh, the best part is that's not a write-in.
Okay, I absolutely, when people try peeing a little bit just to anger the fuck out of me, try doing a natural bodily function that's necessary to survive. Sure, why not? Okay, I absolutely hate it when people try a low standard of living just to anger the fuck out of me, like my stupid ass brother. I absolutely hate it when people try Kanye stress, Kanye West getting some Kanye rest before Kanye Quest to find his Kanye vest so he can get Kanye dressed. I fucking hate you. Okay.
I feel like that card might be winning.
Oh, fucking asshole.
Just to see who it is.
That card. Fucking yes. Dick.
Yeah, it's so fucking it.
Oh my
I absolutely
God.
Hate it when people try frolicking, just to anger the fuck out of me.
Frolicking!
Stop that goddamn happiness!
I absolutely hate it when people try Axe body spray just to anger the fuck out of me. Y'all know it. One of my pick is already, but yeah.
Oh shit.
Woo!
Rinieri,
asshole.
There we go.
VictorVonGroove.
Yes. VictorVonGroove.
Ah,
not groove. I have full time baby birthday baby. Oh, wow. Don't ask, don't tell.
Full time baby's
birthday spanker.
Wow.
Keep that shit in.
I'm keeping it in. I had to make a note for my little slip-up of names, though. After Hurricane Katrina, Sean Penn brought blank to all the people of New Orleans. This would be great if I didn't have the Hurricane Katrina card, and someone still had it in their hands.
In other news, interesting gaming things that have happened in the last week or so.
Yeah.
Anybody?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Anna
they
came
officially
out for
released...
Overwatch.
There you go.
Yeah, Anna came out for Overwatch, which is a support healing sniper without headshots. She's
out
awesome.
Already?
Huh?
That's out already?
Yeah, that's out now. That's in the main game. Fuck. Now.
Do you have that game? Rinieri. I mean,
what?
Rinieri?
Which one? Oh, edit!
Rinieri.
Overwatch.
Edit!
Rinieri.
Rinieri. Rinieri.
It's not Rinieri. It's full time baby spanker.
Okay.
Baby spanker?
Full time baby spanker.
You heard me. Exactly what I said.
I've got a lot of editing to do.
Yes, you do.
God damn it. Okay. Do you have Overwatch full-time baby spanker?
Things that we didn't expect to ever say in our lives.
God damn it.
Things I do, eighth grade cocksucker.
Rooms and feel sad.
Oh, shit.
I'm forcing myself to say it because I normally don't call you that.
No.
But do you have Nobody Overwatch? Calls that.
Katie, if Katie was, or God, I'm sorry. Okay. Katie Broom.
Edit! Okay, request. You should keep in the screaming of edit every time we
Oh, I will. I will do that. I will do exactly that. Do you have Overwatch, Rinieri, VictorVonGroove, full-time birthday yes. spanker? Okay,
yes, I good. Do have Overwatch.
Good. Okay, after Three Hurricane
fucking Christina, hours later,
you should play more.
Yes, you should. Aware. Play Ana. She's awesome. A little hard to work with, but very fun.
Okay.
After Hurricane Katrina, Sean Penn brought HIV to all the people of New Orleans. Why?
He's a giver.
Wow.
After Hurricane Katrina, Sean Penn brought golden showers to all the people of New Orleans.
Piss on those motherfuckers.
Make a hurricane of golden shower.
That would be some science, bitch.
Yeah. Some science nerd in the comments, make it happen. Make the science thing.
I mean, to be fair, the sea is a bunch of, you know, fish water piss. Yeah. So, kind of. Yeah.
Would that be considered a butterfly effect?
What? Peeing what in about the ocean?
Having like a moth flap its wings somewhere and then you fucking some other creatures are pissing on people in Haiti? I don't know what the fuck.
What?
I'm drunk.
I think you had a little too much booze. Mr. Butterfly Shrimp Effect.
Well, okay, then now I'm hungry.
Thank you. I'm so hungry right now, it's not even funny.
After Hurricane Katrina, Sean Penn brought cockfights to all the people of New Orleans. That's... I want to say that was a thing. You just whip your dick out and...
Not that kind of cock.
I don't believe you.
I declare penis war.
Yes, it is that kind of cock
bait. It better be that kind of cock. There's no such thing as chicken fights. Only penis fights.
Then we can make it like a bad porn. Oh yeah, slap my dick with your face. Oh,
but every penis is a lightsaber?
Hey, we're just testing out how well you handle your Schwartz. Well, we were over this already.
Yes. After Hurricane Katrina, Sean Penn brought booby-trapping the house to foil burglars to all the people of New Orleans. Where did that kid live in Home Alone?
All 3 feet of your house that remained. Now booby trap.
I'm going to defend my roof.
That sounds like a game. After Hurricane Katrina, Sean Penn brought a sack full of basketballs to all the people of New Orleans.
That's racist.
Yeah.
Wow.
Who did it?
Wow.
Yes. Brian did it. Brian... Dude, a sack full
of basketballs.
Congratulations,
you racist fucker!
And for those wondering what the total score is at home, you're keeping track of it, not us. I just want to see who's paying attention in the comments.
In other words, we're trying to audibly paint the picture of dudes index finger down, his middle finger up, his ring finger down, and his pinky finger down, and his thumb is down too, cause he's flicking you off. See what I did there? He's got a middle.
You overdid. Yeah. You're trying too hard.
No, I'm not. I'm trying the exact right amount. It's 99.
No, you're wrong.
4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 6.
You're wrong. I don't
By the
care.
Way, Carter, you're not alone. Millions of Americans struggle with the blank spaces on black cards every single day.
Yeah. Well, that's just nasty.
I don't know how this one will go.
Oh, God. Number 4.
Probably a bit of an oblique to the left. Oh, God!
Read it.
You're not alone. Millions of Americans struggle with Will Smith's never-aging cream every single day.
Because remember Willanium?
God.
I have that CD.
You're not alone.
Millions I willingly bought that CD.
Struggle with 72 virgins every single day. Because they're one of them. They are one of the virgins. That's why they struggle together. You're not alone. Millions of Americans struggle with going full potato every single day. I felt like that needed emphasis.
It did.
It's just Kitty Kaboom that goes full potato.
You never go full potato. What the fuck?
You're not alone. Millions of Americans struggle with Donald Trump every single day.
And was the shouting needed? Because I think this is like a thing that should be done in a calm voice with like soothing music in the background and like
Donald Trump. Yeah, it should be. Huge.
But huge. That's just what makes the screaming all that more, you know, necessary, because those things are obnoxious.
True. Okay.
And you're not alone. Millions of Americans struggle with nocturnal emissions every single day.
I agree.
Except for Shro, who has never had a wet dream in his life and really, really, really just wants to have one wet dream because it would be fantastic.
Not really, dude. They're really not that all cracked up.
Just don't wank for like 4 weeks.
Exactly. Just let it go.
Remember what happened last time I took a shit and came.
Oh, yeah. That happened.
Wow, you share a lot on this podcast.
Yes, he does. We all do.
Remember and that time summer... I took a shit and I blew a load? No. What happened? Cool.
See, this is why we have followers.
Yeah, it's probably true.
Oh, shit. Oh, God. It's just...
Oh, right, I'm supposed to pick a card.
I shared the fact that he fucking blew a hole and he took a dump. No, I haven't seen that one. Don't ever listen to it. It's scarring. I gotta hear it now.
It's that reverse psychology in action.
Don't listen to it. I gotta listen to it now.
I can't help it.
Hey, Donald Trump wins with Firetits McGee on the thing. I'm a setter score. 10.
Mr. Oh, Dude Butt here did not listen to me when I told him to lower the score.
I wasn't
the one who made it. Oh. That was SquaZ.
Yeah, SquaZ. So how SquaZ high are we going?
Is your one to blame.
Damn it, dude. Why didn't you lower SquaZ's ticker?
God damn it, dude.
I had to remind him to put in 30 blank cards.
I asked. I was like, do you guys want to play till. Like, what, till 8, 9, 10?
I heard
10,
nothing
and nobody said
from
anything.
And then like, you have a very quiet voice that blends in and you should have typed. I also had to remind you to put 30 blank cards.
I just tasted my fucking lunch.
You're not
disgusting.
Dangerous enough for us to hear you, SquaZ. You need to type.
Gross. Wow.
Disgusting, sir.
Also, that was a nice break.
Oh, God, now I'm hungry for nuggets again. God damn it.
Gotta have those nuggets.
If I left right now, I taste cake and ice cream.
Ooh.
Yep.
Alright, I guess we're gonna keep going. What's my secret power?
So I guess that is a good question. Sir Dude Butt, what does the recording timer say?
54 minutes and 38 seconds counting up.
Keep it going!
Well, I'm sure we can cut some parts.
Yeah, well, no, we make this a 2 week
marathon
deal.
Marathon.
We'll go until somebody wins.
There it is. What is my secret power? A super soaker full of cat pee.
Though keep in mind, with the length this way, it's probably gonna have to go up on YouTube only. So YouTube exclusive. Whoop-de-doo.
And you shall name me. Super Soaker Cat Pee Man.
All right, well, that was SquaZ.
The cat pisser.
What's my secret power? Grinder hookups. What's my secret power? Fucking awesome. What's my secret power? Roofies.
And you go to sleep. And you go to sleep.
What's my secret power? Roofies.
Is it supposed to be Bill Cosby?
Shut up, fucker! It was good then! My secret power is literally anything else.
Aww.
Your secret power is this? Nope. Try again. I'm going to have to do this because he's just so sad.
SquaZ wins with literally anything else.
What, you got laser for eyes? Nope. Try again.
His superpower is being able to continue that discussion forever.
You can fly? Nope.
Well, what can you do?
Literally everything else. We still have to figure that out, don't we?
On my deathbed, my last thoughts will be of blank.
The cannon.
Sorry. I'm still dying for that last one.
All good.
Good times.
Ooh, God, that was good.
Hey, so did you guys see that they actually officially announced the retro Nintendo Entertainment System? The
one that's
I really need that. I need it.
I want it. I need that in my life.
If I had a television, I'd be all over it.
You can hook sure up your monitor as a HDMI port.
On my deathbed, my last thoughts will be of nuking the whales.
We're whalers on the moon. We carry a big nuke.
My last thoughts will be of stifling a giggle at the mention of Huttus and Tutsis.
Wow, you butchered that one.
My deathbed. I have no idea what that is.
The Hutus and the Tutsis.
Whatever. On my deathbed, my last thoughts will be of racism.
Yeah, fuck
Which is bleep. Basically the same thing as the last card, yeah. Except the last card was mass murder. Okay.
On my deathbed, my last thoughts will be of selling Detroit for scrap.
Racist.
Again, racist. On my deathbed, my last thoughts will be of a ShamWow.
Racist.
Because they can really soak it up.
Racist.
Racist.
Actually, just druggy.
Racist.
Just because of how ridiculous it is.
SquaZ wins with ShamWow.
Dude.
Getting close.
Whales.
Racism was a close second.
Whales are evil. What the fuck?
Oh, they're not. They're beautiful, majestic,
just discovered
and huge.
A new planet in the solar system. It is believed to have life forms of your mother. And something else.
Exclamation point.
Okay.
Your father. Just keep going.
So I'm gonna keep talking about this Nintendo Retro. I just want it for the two Zelda games.
Yeah, I want it for almost everything that's on it. That's just me.
So I actually have my old NES system, and it still functions, and I have games for it, and they all still work, including the original Legend of Zelda. But I don't have Legend of Zelda 2. Makes me sad.
For 60 bucks,
Adventure of Legend of Zelda, The Adventure of Legend of Zelda.
I actually thought when I looked at that list, I was like hoping for Battletoads, and I'm like, wait, that's Battletoads SNES. Is the SNES. Exactly. Yeah. I was like, oh... I guess I'm going to have to buy their SNES cube again.
That's a thing?
No, I'm probably... But they're going to sell so many copies of that Nintendo thing that they're for sure they're going to make an SNES version.
Someone put me in there.
You know when that fucking comes out, because I'll get that in a matter of seconds. Oh
someone
my God.
Put me in the
card. SNES?
Hell yeah.
All right. NASA discovered... A new planet is believed to have life forms of dude butts and noodles.
Well. I'm not the czar, though, so I can't pick that.
It is believed to have life forms of guys who don't call and Judge Judy.
So other guys that don't call.
Cookie Monster devouring Eucharistic Eucharist wafers. I butchered that.
Someone show SquaZ how to pronounce it.
The church bread wafers.
Wafers.
Would you like to have yourself a water?
Wafers.
Would you want to have one little tiny water cupper?
Wooly wooly wafers.
Okay, who's this? So there's the W is like wah wah, and then the A is ah, so wah first.
You fucking rich.
Waffer cracker.
Waffers.
Waffer.
I say, I will be fair. There is a language barrier there, and it is a fucky word. But it is really funny to hear somebody
say that. It would be W-E-Y-F-E-R-E-S.
Shiro, I understand you want to be a har-har.
And civilian casualties.
That would be true, except that we are American English, and American English sometimes is stupid.
So let's not lie here. English, period, is stupid.
Yes.
The easiest language in the world.
No, it's not. It's just one of the most ubiquitous.
Yeah. It's easiest to
learn. We have a regular A that we don't need to put a Y with, just so you know.
I would love to go there, too.
I'm going to keep it going.
Sorry.
Please go ahead.
It is believed to have life forms of rules and take-backsies, which break the rules. Unless the rule is to take backsies, in which case it's kind of redundant.
Oh, the asteroid hit the planet. Take backsies!
All the take backsies.
Life forms of a giant bee and William Shatner. I am so living on this planet.
Hell no!
Buzz.
Giant bees
buzz.
And William Shatner.
And the winner of that was Brian Lee, buzz, William buzz, Shatner one.
Buzz.
What the fuck is it with being Kanye West, okay? Really?
Damn it, I wish I had that card going again.
In his new self-produced album, Kanye West raps over the sounds of...
I think mine's relevant, but I'm not sure. It could be.
Is it about Kanye West?
I don't know. This guy's all over the place.
All the Kanye West.
Then it probably is about Kanye West.
Have you guys read his tweets?
No, I don't follow him on Twitter.
You don't even have to follow him. Just like hashtag look for him and just read his page for like an hour and you'd be like, what the fuck?
It's almost like reading Donald Trump's page for like 3 seconds.
Speaking of Trump, there was an erotica fiction of him on the Kindle store. It was like a dollar, and it got top seller when it came out. It's like three chapters. A genius. It's fucking awesome. I'll pull it up in a bit if you want to read it, but yeah, go on.
In his new self-produced album, Kanye West raps over the sounds of homosexual fish sticks. Touching. In his new self-produced album, Kanye West raps over the sounds of attitude. Yep. In his new self-produced album, Kanye West raps over the sounds of Kanye doing Kanye things when he's thinking about Kanye things.
Someone fucked up.
You just dropped the ball, son.
In his new self-produced album, Kanye West raps over the sounds of canceling your monthly payment to sponsor your child so you can afford a second iPad. Didn't he just bitch on Twitter put things on, what is it, the
GoFundMe
that he was out of money?
Words? I have no idea what the hell that... No, I haven't heard that, anything about that.
Yeah, I do believe he was trying to raise money on GoFundMe because he was broke.
Because he's going to go to prison because him and fucking Kim released a goddamn audio tape of
Taylor Swift,
yeah, without her knowledge, and apparently that's illegal in California.
It's illegal everywhere. In his new self-produced album, Kanye West raps over the sounds of Bosnian chicken farmers. He would totally fucking find a way to do that. I'm sorry.
SquaZ, so it was Bosnian relevant. Chicken farmers.
It was relevant.
Well played.
I am the card czar. Play the best card in your hand or feel my wrath. Blank exclamation point.
No. The other way around.
No. I am the card czar. I will read it however the fuck I want to read it. It's like I'm now tempted to read a passage from Trump Temptation, the businessman and the bellboy. The billionaire and the bellboy, my bad.
Good times, dude. Good times.
I don't know. Let's find a good one. I was stacking someone's tacky luggage when the door behind me swapped open. My loins trembled as the scent of toupee adhesive and spray tan swept through my nasal cavity. I wanted nothing more than to turn around and see the golden god behind these scents, but I couldn't move. I was frozen. There was a tap on my shoulder. Young man, the voice said, I thought to myself. Oh god, could this be him? There was only one way to be sure. I gathered all of my strength and turned around. Was I hallucinating? This couldn't be real. It was him. And it was Donald. He stood there in front of me like a tall stallion, with his oily orange skin glistening in the sunlight as if he were a soggy Cheeto. His hair unkempt and messy like a gorgeous rat's nest. Okay, I'll start picking the...
Wow.
Wow.
Fucking awesome.
I am the card czar. Play the best card in your hand if you're my wrath. Half-assed foreplay. Vladimir, the Soviet love machine. Making a hot new single so the planet won't get destroyed. Blank. And lubricant. Well, this is just a thrower way around.
No. Oh, come on. Play the best card in your hand. I played a blank card. It's blank.
Well, I don't know what to pick.
This is meta, man.
It's funny.
Fucking meta on your god.
I can't
it. Shit. Fuck.
You crazy bullshit.
I can't pick anything. I am incapable of picking something if there's nothing funny to go with the sentence. And the sentence is fucking bullshit. So, what? Also, fire tits. Oh, shit. Also, fire tits. McGee.
I'm still gonna be here, but I'm just gonna leave the card game here.
Oh, okay then, Mr. Forfeiting.
What a douche.
Fire tits McGee won the round with making a hot new single so the planet won't get destroyed, and Shro is mad.
Because he lost a blank card for playing a blank card as a blank card.
Yeah.
So meta.
Meta as fuck. Anyways. Hello,
Brian, don't forget to hit leave game.
He fucked up.
Yeah?
Don't forget to hit leave game if you're leaving the card game. Because then you'll be in here forever and we won't be able to move on.
Oh, give me one
second. Okay.
My new screensaver is a photo of blank next to blank.
Alright, there you go. That should work.
No. No, you're still in.
Well, I picked a card now.
Oh, okay, cool.
Oh.
Well, okay, that's...
Didn't see it on my end.
Brian,
okay.
On the top left, don't close your browser. You need to click on the leave game button.
And it also says you didn't pick a card.
You have to confirm select.
There we go. Okay.
Though I will, however, make a motion that we should probably bring things to a close here. End of the round or not.
Very soon.
Yeah.
It is 2 in the morning.
Guess it is. Meh.
still early.
He's very much so.
It's only 11.
Exactly.
In your time zone. In ours, it's 2 in the morning.
It's not her, her birthday isn't over yet, so.
True.
Yeah,
true.
That's right.
Get over it.
We'll
my new screensaver is a photo of statistically validated stereotypes next to licking things to claim them as your own. How does that work? Anyways, my new screensaver is a photo of The Little Mermaid on VHS next to Rhonda Rousey. See, I might have said that wrong. I don't even know.
Oh, Rhonda Rousey.
Whatever it is now, it's part of our world.
Yep.
Oh, my. I got it.
Yeah, what?
That was terrible, dude.
I know. I know.
I got it when he first said it, but nobody else does. So, yes, there was a joke, you know. Wish I could be a part of your world. Okay.
Yeah. We get it. We know it's terrible.
Oh, my.
Squaz,
my new screensaver is a photo of deflowering the princess. That's a good photo. Next to pipes. Lots of pipes.
Is this my copyright?
We're not making money off it, so whatever.
My new screensaver is a photo of purple disco pants next to American gladiators. That aren't
those
wearing
are generally
purple disco
one
pants.
And the same.
Oh my god, guys. What did you? I just want to see people lick statistically validated stereotypes.
I cannot believe my pipes did not win. Okay.
That's true. Pipes should have probably won. I regret everything.
It says peach porn. Yeah.
Are you there, God? It's me, blank. Are you there, God? It's me, blank. It's me, Steven.
It's me, Butt Plunger.
It's me, Raoul.
Raoul.
Are you there, God? It's me, Brooklyn's finest police force.
The
are you there, God?
The...
It's me, self-loathing. Are you there, God? It's me, getting drunk on mouthwash. Oh, my God. Are you there, God? It's me, Assless Chaps.
Mm. Fabulous.
Fabulous.
Those are fun.
Yeah.
These are all crazy. These are all crazy.
Crazy.
If I was a Catholic, I would pick a certain thing. I know what I'm talking about.
I don't know. Oh, okay.
Do it. Yes.
Self-loathing wins. Shro gets the point.
Making fun
oh my.
Of Jesus.
In
describe yourself in one word or phrase.
Well, hopefully mine's accurate. So how about that local sports weather team?
Okay. If you describe yourself in one word or phrase. Oh, dude. This year's mass shooting. Wow.
Oh no.
Wow.
That is dark.
I'm going to make this worse. Which one this week?
Yeah.
Pixelated bukkake, glory holes, and a rap song that doesn't mention girls, monies, and cars. So
monies?
Will Smith's album.
Monies?
Monies and car.
Monies.
Yes. So a Will Smith album.
Okay.
Monies.
So this is funny because whatever I pick is going to describe the actual winner. I'll have that image in my head.
Yeah. Oh.
And just because it's so wrong. There we go.
Mass shootings won. Firetits McGee got the point.
I am judging you.
Oh, shit. That's awesome.
I'm sorry, Professor, but I couldn't complete my homework because of large amounts of copious fucking.
Okay. Yes.
I used, and look, and I even said large amounts twice, large amounts and copious. There yes. you go.
Well, one in four could technically, well, one technically be
not. Counting, it's difficult.
Words and counting with beer at 2 a.m.
I'm sorry.
User are apparently not allowed to do anything with alcohol.
Yeah. You're not dangerous enough.
I couldn't complete my homework because I am doing Kegels right now. I'm sorry, I couldn't complete my homework because of leveling up. I'm sorry, Professor, but I couldn't complete my homework because of dying of dysentery. That would probably be a problem. Claire has died of dysentery.
It certainly prevents you from doing anything on the Oregon Trail.
Warrior needs food badly.
Speaking of that, I want to get back into that game. Gauntlet.
I'm sorry, Professor, but I couldn't complete my homework because of hardcore vaginal bleeding.
Because we were doing too many Kegels.
Shouldn't involve the same muscles.
Shouldn't.
But it did.
Someone did their
Something
Kegels wrong.
Something has gone wrong.
Kegels wins. Full-time birthday spanker has the point.
Woo! Do a Kegel.
Woo! Ready?
Oh, yeah, you can bleep that. I'm sorry.
Edit! Edit!
Ow! Okay. Someone gonna say the name so I can, like, put it over? Okay, fine. Full-time birthday spanker.
Full-time spanker.
Rumor has it that Vladimir Putin's favorite delicacy is blank stuffed with blank.
Not gonna lie, I read this card and just went, rumor has it that Vladimir Putin's favorite delicacy is stuffed. That was it.
Stuffed blank.
No blanks. No other words.
Exactly. Just stuffed.
Stuffed.
Stuffed penis. I really want sushi right now. Like, really bad. Also, that second one, holy shit. Rumor has it that Vladimir Putin's favorite delicacy is good grammar stuffed with putting the emphasis on the wrong syllable. Rumor has it that Vladimir Putin's favorite delicacy is the ISIS flying a plane into Trump Tower stuffed with bling.
Okay.
Conflicted on that one. Rumor has it that Vladimir Putin's favorite delicacy is friendly fire stuffed with mutually assured destruction. Rumor has it that Vladimir Putin's favorite delicacy is loose lips stuffed with the gaze.
Ooh. Political!
Torn between two, but both make me an asshole.
I love those ones.
Yeah.
Oh, you are playing cards, so...
In a podcast, too.
Go with the one that makes you the biggest asshole.
Okay. Slips and McGee's wins, and full-time birthday spanker, a.k.a. Rinieri, a.k.a. Victor Von Groove, a.k.a. get a shorter name that we can stick with, please. That's the point.
Relevant to a conversation we were having earlier.
Oh, yeah, we were talking about The Rock. Shrow.
No.
We were.
That's not what I was talking about.
Oh, really?
Oh, wait, I am the cards, are yeah.
But we were actually discussing The Rock at some point. How he was...
correct, but yeah. That's not what I was talking about.
What were you talking about? Go on. All right,
this card confuses me.
I think it's grammatically not correct.
It's grammatically not correct for like 7 reasons. If you smell, exclamation point, what blank is cooking, exclamation point.
Yeah, it's fucked up.
If you smell, what making your stuffed animal self-filate is cooking.
Say that again? What?
What? If you smell, what the milkman that visits your wife unusually too often is cooking. If you smell, what is cooking. If you smell, what shaft is cooking?
Well, that third one was Fancy Feast, if it cut out for anybody else in the feed.
No, that's just sure that's doing the William Shatner.
Mm. If you smell, what the...
Yay!
Full-time birthday spanker coming from behind. Your stuffed animal self-filet has won.
Spanking them plush animals.
Yes. Oh god, I have the perfect one for this.
In a bold move, Disney has dedicated to make an animated movie about blank.
Decided.
Well, if they can make Inside Out, they can make what I'm doing, what I'm about to post.
Oh my god!
Oh god.
In a bold move, Disney has decided to make an animated movie about coat hanger abortions. In a bold move, Disney has decided to make an animated movie about the entire periodic table. In a bold move, Disney has dedicated to make an animated movie about a group of nuns having sex in the eyes of the Lord. Oh my god! In a bold move, Disney has decided to make an animated movie about pulling out. Oh my god.
Ah, damn it. Cunninger abortions won. Shro got it. I wasted the nun's card. Fuck.
I don't know. Pulling out is the
Did you pull out, Goofy? You sure? Are you sure?
Should I pull out? No? Okay then.
In his summer, Jesus Christ.
Bridget face.
In his new summer comedy, Rob Schneider is blank, trapped in the body of blank.
Don't forget to pull out, Pluto.
Why can't I leave it there?
Rob Schneider is
derp-de-derp.
Yes.
Yeah.
Just
in his new summer comedy, Rob Schneider is his blank trapped in the body of blank.
The stapler.
Derp-de-derp-de-derp-de-derp. Bird PG-13.
Do you want to read the rest? That was an amazing
You add
voice.
A thing to it. You add something to it when you read it that
way. Good luck, Tro.
No, SquaZ. Good luck, SquaZ.
Why do I have to read it? I can do it if you want me to.
SquaZ.
Can you make a Rob Schneider voice?
I can.
Well, then by all means.
Not a Rob Schneider voice. Schumer, it's a fucking comedy.
Rob Schneider is not reciprocating oral sex trapped in the body of an asymmetric boob job. I'd somehow I turned into a fucking Muppet. I don't know.
PG-13.
Wow, that's...
Okay, do it as Fozzie Bear. Fozzie Bear is, in today's new summer comedy, Rob Schneider is Waka Waka Waka.
Waka Waka, that one kid in school that everybody likes, trapped in the body of Mr. Snuffleupagus.
Snuffleupagus.
Mr. Snuffleupagus.
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 I've never been to the last group of cards.
Snuffleupagus. Rob Schneider is only being able to get it up when a cat watches. Trapped in the body of Übermensch. Schneider is trapped, is a 5 kilogram dumbbell trapped in the body of that black guy who makes sound effects at the police academy.
Shro wins it with the police academy cards.
I like that guy.
He was in Spaceballs.
Yes, he was. He was.
And that's what I was trying to do with the Raider sound, but I'm not as good as him.
We got the creeps, and the creeps, and the speed. It's not the only thing we got.
Same sound for all three.
All right. Here's your new winner and new WWE champion.
Oh my god.
I have nothing for this, but wrong guy. Never mind.
Oh my. Somebody had the perfect layout card for that. Here's your winner and new WWE champion of threesome.
We're gonna make a risk in editing for this next card. Go.
Wait for it. Get the
No,
the sound.
No, I'm gonna edit that into the video. Oh, okay. This is YouTube exclusive, so whatever.
And here is your new winner and new WWE champion.
And his name is John Cena.
Here is your winner and new WWE champion, that stupid asshole with all the awesome points.
AKA Firetits McGee.
Oh my god, that is
who is currently winning.
I love that. That's perfect.
SquaZ wins the point with stupid asshole who has all the awesome points.
The fucking game is lasting forever.
I know.
SquaZ wins the point by insulting the Tsar. Nice.
Do we want to end it with this one round? Because I'm not going to win.
We could.
Yeah. Okay.
This one for all the marbles.
I have decided to become an... Oh, go for it.
That's mine card.
Oh my god! Please don't move. Oh god!
Oh god!
Let the record show he's doing that to himself.
I have decided to become an activist and fight against Tro reading my goddamn card. Decided to become an activist and fight for blank. Did you slap the mic?
I did!
Why?
I didn't mean to.
Oh, god damn it. Hey.
Oh my god.
Hey, this is for all the marbles. I cannot win.
Let it note that I am on my sixth.
Sixth what?
Masturbation, what? Orgasm.
Pinching one out.
Beer, that's nothing.
With the third eyeball and gonorrhea.
Sneezing to orgasm.
Sixth gonorrhea.
Pooping and coming.
Eh. If it tickles just right, I can understand. Just right.
If it tickles just right, right, dude. Oh my god.
Finally. Okay.
Oh, shit. I was laughing too hard.
I have decided to become an activist and fight for me time.
God damn it. Right.
Actually, that does sound good. Having some time to down. I'm not even kidding. That does sound really good, just to like have some time to unwind from a life of fucking working nonstop. All day, every day.
Fun. Fun times.
I've decided to become an activist and fight for racially biased SAT questions. I've decided to become
a Trump supporter.
I've decided to become an activist and fight for scalping. Ugh.
Racist. Funny, but racist.
I've decided to become an activist and fight for just a whole room full of penis juice. Whoever picked this one knows me too well, and I don't know if I want to pick it. Oh, fuck it. Penis Juice wins, and Shrell wins
we
the game.
We have a winner! And it's the birthday girl!
Well, it is technically the birthday girl.
Yeah. By points, birthday girl Firetits McGee wins, but by last round, who got the pick? Shrell won, so... Second place goes to Shrell.
By points! Points,
yes. Points-wise, though, Firetits McGee wins.
Yep, she's still the asshole with all the points.
Yes.
Making a pretty good comeback.
And we'll start the outro with this last card. We'll start the outro with this last card. Shro, would you do the honors?
Why? Why do I hurt all over?
Because you tried to read my card, Shro. You brought it upon yourself.
I said I was sorry.
I didn't hear the word sorry come out of your mouth.
Again, why did you get the
perfect card to end it with?
Puts the lotion in the basket or it gets the hose again, Shro. Okay, I think we're getting a little too dark now.
Yeah, we are.
Yeah.
And put the lotion on the back, you're gonna get the hold again.
So thank you guys for joining us on our Cards Against Humanity / birthday celebration for Firetits McGee / podcast.
3 fucking hours long.
Yeah,
never
hour and a half
fucking
actually.
Ended.
Oh, we're still going, because I still see like one person hasn't played the card, if they left or not. I don't know.
He's not playing.
Oh, me. I'm sorry.
Okay.
God damn it!
We'll end with this last one. Like, not the round, because we already know who won, but...
Well, I've already bailed.
Yeah.
I pressed.
Yeah, you bailed, so you lost.
Well, wait. Fuck off.
Loser!
No, Mr. Not Dangerous Enough for anything.
Why do I hurt all over? A tasty cake recipe that I beat myself with at every corner of my life.
You know, there is a YouTube channel where they do actually do that.
What? Wait, what?
There's a YouTube channel called Swedish Meal Time. They basically just beat the shit out of their food.
They beat the food.
Do they go hurdy, gurdy, 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 furdy?
No, they do shout things in Swedish and English and do really crazy shit after shouting Swedish style.
But like, then they
all right, gentlemen, this is it for me. I really have to go, so good night.
SquaZ. We're still recording now.
All right, good night, SquaZ.
Don't forget to pull out, Pluto!
I love you!
Get it out of my ass!
Okay, go.
Watching a game of basketball with an all-white team. That's why I hurt all over.
Racism.
So they're all white, not from their skin. but from something else.
Oh my. Why do I hurt all over? Media coverage in the United States.
You went Clinton there for a minute. Why do I hurt all over?
You can control your voice. Cause my voice is a fucking schizophrenic.
Why do I hurt all over?
I did the tasty not have cupcake sex with recipe. An all-white team. They were
watching
black when
a
I
game
did it.
With a fresh ball of an all-white team. I like the Negro. Too much. Too far.
I'm still recording.
I know. That's why you said my name.
God damn it.
Edit.
Double edit. Double edit. Double edit. I got a sense throughout the word he said and my name, the name that I said. Fuck.
It's not a bad word.
No, it's not a bad word.
I don't.
It's not a PC word, but it's not a bad word.
True. It's still a thing we gotta watch for, though.
Well, I'm watching it.
Okay.
I didn't say
a thing.
Word. I didn't say it. Bill Clinton did.
That mean old former president.
I like the dark chocolate.
I inhale. Take a card. So you can end this.
Uh-oh. I didn't think we were going to end the card.
Well, all right, then.
I'm going to end it on a cliffhanger. Woo!
Woo!
All right, then. Bye, everybody.
Good night, everybody.